I call the honourable member Gerry Brownlee.
Mr Speaker, might I reply briefly to the comments made by Steve Mahari about a matter that we consider to be extremely important. And that is the issue of trying to curb the excesses of violence against children in this country. And the point I want to make is that we are not going to follow blindly a Labor Party line that says sit in a room, wring your hands, get a few more committees together, have a commission somewhere, go through all those sort of steps that they'd normally go through on all sorts of issues, and never come under any scrutiny, never come under any scrutiny in the Parliament, because everybody is bought into it. Well, our role, sir, is to be in opposition. Our role is to hold the government to account. And on behalf of the many children whose lives are made miserable by government failure in this matter, we will hold the government to account and not be sitting in a room somewhere being told what to do by the minister. One of the most interesting things about question time today was the response that the Honourable Mark Burton gave to the Honourable Bill English when Mr English asked him some questions about the need for there to be an election period in New Zealand that is, in the case of next year, likely to run for some 11 months. Not just the standard 3 months that we've always had, not the 6 weeks that you have in Canada, not even the proportionate 12 months that you have in the 5-year cycle in Britain, but a whole 11 months inside a 3-year parliamentary term in New Zealand. And for those 11 months, the government is attempting to shut down criticism, to shut down any opposition to their policy program. They virtually said to New Zealanders, if we do something, it's okay. If National does something, it's wrong. And so we're going to bring in a law that says what we did is okay and what they did isn't, and New Zealanders can lump it. The problem with this is that it is a direct attack on the freedom of speech that makes New Zealand such a wonderful country that it is. And we saw today the minister actually standing in the House and suggesting that there were already billboards out there attacking the government, and therefore those attacking the government must be the friends of the National Party. Well, let me tell you, Mr Burton, there are thousands of New Zealanders who've invested in forestry in this country who are not happy with the government's policy regarding the reuse of land and the cost of carbon credits, and they have every right to say what they like about Labor's policy in that regard without the sort of accusation that you might like to, Mr Speaker, that the member might like to make about them. And to think that there is going to be a law now constructed around the idea that any criticism of the Labor Party, any criticism of the government, is somehow at the hands of the opposition parties or hand in hand with the opposition party and therefore must be shut down because it may influence an election, is a dreadful step for this country to be taking. So we want to ask the Minister and the Labor Party, why such a long period of time? Yeah. What is it they're afraid of? Why can't they have any New Zealander who wants to question them do so freely during a period of 12 months prior to an election? What's so frightening about the scrutiny that ordinary New Zealanders will put on a government? I think, Mr Speaker, that is a question the government is going to need to answer over the next couple of weeks. Because if we go much further than that, then of course New Zealanders are going to have no say on this matter whatsoever. Because Helen Clark has decreed that this will be law by November. And the Minister stood up day after day and said there are matters the Select Committee should be dealing with. But at the same time he said, we are going to bring in an SOP, which is effectively a new law, at the time it comes back into the House, and we're going to jackboot our proposals through this House, and we are going to shut down anyone who wants to criticise us in any way whatsoever. The worst, of course, is that this bill is before the Parliament at the same time that the Chief of Staff from the Prime Minister's office is trying to collude with other parties to enable members of Parliament to spend any amount they like from their members' support budget in election activities or on election activities. And we know, sir, that people are aware that after the last election, when there was the dreadful rort over the pledge card, right, Michael Cullen came into this House and pushed through a bill that made everything that had been illegal legal for a period until the 31st of December 2007.
Order.
And so what they're now saying is that when that expires in 2007, there has to be a new law in place that continues to make that legal. It's a disgrace, it's an attack on freedom of speech, and it will cost Labor big.
Speaker,
I call the